children.
Yes. So you have learned the lesson in social science history part, right? So I already said that there is a history, civics and the geography, isn't it? So today we are going to learn one more lesson from geography. Okay, so geography part now we are learning. What is that geography? What does it mean? Yes. Okay, geography means it is the study of the earth's surface, right? Or continents, or countries, town, location, boundaries, ocean, mountain, or the physical features, everything, physical features of the earth's surface or the continent, countries of the earth. So about the earth we are all learning in geography today. Okay, so today one more lesson like that, globe and the maps. And before that, do you know about the earth is the third planet of the our solar system, isn't it? Okay, so we are all living in the earth. You already learnt in the fifth standard that is earth is a living planet, isn't it? And it is having unique features, right? Okay, so today I'm going to explain about the difference between the maps as well as the globe. What is that globe, children? Have you seen this globe? Yes, this is called globe, isn't it? Yes. So we can't recognize the parts of the earth, isn't it? For that reason we are all using the globe. So this globe is a model of the earth or miniature model of the earth. What is that globe? It globe is a miniature model of the earth. Are you seeing? Yes, children. Okay, so we can't study whole part of the earth, isn't it? So that our geographist, they made the globe. Okay, so this globe is the shape of the earth only. Okay, children. It is sometimes they will say orange shape, sometimes they will say oval shape, isn't it? And we are telling it is a spherical. What is that? Spherical, children. Or geoid shape. What is that? Geoid shape. Okay. What are the uses of this globe, children? Globe is a miniature model of the earth, we said, isn't it? So what is the use? Okay, I'll say that first of all, it is to know about the shape of the earth and the size of the earth. Yes, what is the globe? What is that? It is a miniature model of the earth. And how it will be uses for us? And it will be uses for us like it is to know about the shapes and the size. Shape means it is a looking like a ball, isn't it? And another thing is this globe is little bit right side. It's all natural. Yes, it is. For example, just you take down. Okay. Yes. Your earth is, however you can keep it, one side it is little bit tilted. Yes or not? Yes. So here we can know about the earth's shape, size, direction. Okay. What is the direction we can see? For example, the head part of the earth is, it is northern part. And the down it is, what is that? Yes. It is south. North and the south. The same thing. What is that? East and the west. Okay, east and the western part we can see. Apart from that, what we can see here? Have can you observe in the globe some yellow line? Yes, children. It is the largest latitude. What is that? It is an imaginary line. It is drawn on the globe at the middle, children. So this equator is divided the earth into two halves. One is northern hemisphere, one is southern hemisphere. Okay. So here, this grid, what we call that, children? This is the equator part. Already you know about the latitude and the longitude, isn't it, children? So this grid of the line is called, yes, from the north to south, it is a vertical, isn't it? So this vertical line is called longitude and the horizontal line. Yes, have you seen? So this horizontal line is called latitude. So five latitudes we know about that. Yes or not? What is that? Equator, Tropic of Cancer, Arctic Circle, and here Tropic of Capricorn, Antarctic Circle. So there is a five latitudes. What are they, children? Equator, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Arctic Circle, and Antarctic Circle. Isn't it? So latitudes as well as the longitudes we can see in this globe, size we can see, shape of the earth we can see. Apart from that, there will be a continent, children. For example, here the Arctic Circle, isn't it? So here what we can see? Okay, for example, here North America and here South America, as well as here Europe, here Africa, then Asia, what is that? Asia, then here Australia, we can see that. Yes or not, children? Yes, what is that? There are seven continents and the countries we can see. What are the seven continents? You know that, isn't it? What is that? North America, South America. What is that? North America, South America, Asia, Africa, Europe, Australia. Then the last one is, what is that? Antarctica. Yes, so there is seven continents we can locate easily on the globe. Okay, apart from that, latitude and the longitude it has mentioned here, children. Then the direction, east, west, and south, and north. North, south, east, and the west also it is located on the globe. Okay, this is the uses of the globe, children. And another thing we can learn, or we can understand the inclination of the earth's axis. For example, I already said it is little bit tilted, means so 23.5 degree it is tilted towards. Okay, children. So yes, this is end of the pole. What is that? Northern pole. This end of the point is called North Pole, and here it is South Pole. Okay, so, and another thing we know about or understand about how earth is revolving and how earth is rotating. What is that? Because of the rotation. What is that rotation? Yes, for example, this is the axis line, isn't it? Yes, here earth is tilted 23.5 degree, I already said, isn't it? So here from west to east, what is that? From west to east, it is rotating itself on its axis. Means on its axis only this earth is rotating. This is called rotation, children. Because of the rotation, we are having the day and night. For example, here the sunlight is coming. So it is, this earth's face it is towards to the sun, isn't it? Earth's face is towards to the sun. So that in this part it is having the day. Again, here there is no sunlight. It is far away from the sun, isn't it? So that this part is called night. So this is when the sun is in the eastern part, then the eastern part of the earth will get day, and the western part it is away from the sun, no, so that it is having night. Okay, so children, so according to the sunlight or the earth's rotation, we are having the day and night. And one more thing, already you know about that, how it will be revolving, isn't it? So earth is revolving, it rotating itself also, as well as revolving around the sun, that you know, isn't it? So all the planets are revolving around the sun. The same thing here, because of the earth revolution on its fixed path, where there is a path or the way, According to that line, fixed path or orbital line, only Earth is revolving. So that this revolution causes season, children. What is that? Season. For example, here northern part is tilted to the sun, isn't it? So that northern hemisphere, it is getting the summer, and the southern part, it is away from the sun, means it will be far, so that it is having winter. Okay children, so summer season and the winter season you will get it. Okay, so when the earth is revolving around the sun during that time, because of the revolution, what it will happen? Seasons will happen. Because of the rotation, day and night will happen. Revolution, it is season, it will change us. Okay, so this is the uses of the globe. But there is a one small problem is there. What is that? Globe is very heavy, isn't it? We cannot take it very easily. And small, small part of the towns or cities or the countries we cannot identify on the globe, isn't it? It is only, large scale. So it is, we can't identify all the small, small location we cannot. Small, small boundaries we cannot. Only 7 continents we can, and the oceans we can, isn't it? What are the oceans, children? Yes. For example, this is called Pacific Ocean. There's a 5 major ocean. Pacific Ocean, and here Atlantic Ocean, and here Southern Ocean, and Indian Ocean. Where is that Indian Ocean? Yes, here Indian Ocean we can see. Apart from that, here in the northern part, Arctic Ocean we can see. In the southern part, means above the Antarctica. So there we can see the Southern Ocean. So 5 major oceans we can study. So 7 continents and 5 major oceans we can study on the globe. Then continents, isn't it? We can identify. Then shape and size of the earth we can identify. Then direction as well as the latitude as well as longitude. This we can learn in this globe. But because of the confusion, our geographists, they made the map, children. What is that map? So this map is, there is a 2 types. One is based on the scale, another one is based on the purpose. Means purposefully we are using. For example, India's physical features, if we want, then we can get it Indian physical map, isn't it? Or physical features of India map we will get it. Or political, and political features of or political India political map. So like that we can. And world map, whole earth we have to study, isn't it? We cannot study whole the earth's part, everything. We can't study on this globe. So that they were made the map. Okay, so this map, what is the map? Okay, I say that map is a diagrammatic earth's representation. For example, shape and size we can know about in this globe, but where there is a continents are there in the whole world, that we can know. And about oceans we can learn. And which are the places, physical features, political, means countries, towns, cities, everything we can locate in the map very easily. And another thing is, we can carry this map wherever we go, isn't it, children? For example, you are going to the bus. Suddenly, bus driver, he will put a brake. Then what you will do? So you are holding this globe, isn't it? Suddenly, globe with you, globe also it will fall off. But if you are holding the map, yes, it will not fall off, isn't it? Why? Because it is easy to carry, it is heavy to carry, children. Okay, so that is a major difference. And another thing is, we can locate everything in this map. So it is based on the scale, it is a diagrammatic. For example, we cannot know how is India, what is the shape of the India or North America or South America, where is ocean, everything, isn't it? So we can see in this whole map. Not only this, here also we can the longitude as well as the latitude grid lines, children. Okay. Now I can show you what is that here. Asia. What is that? Asia. Then Europe, Africa, and North America, South America, and Australia, and here Antarctica. The same thing. Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Southern Ocean, Indian Ocean, as well as Arctic Ocean. So like this, we can identify the land boundaries, children. For example, here from North America to South America, where it is here, the we can see the boundaries. The same thing, India, it is bordered to its neighboring countries. Which are the neighboring countries? Pakistan, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Myanmar, Nepal, is it not? And China, isn't it? Or Bhutan. So like this, boundaries, land boundaries, we can see ocean part or the water bodies, lakes, everything we can identify through this map. So this map is based on the scales. For example, what is the meaning of scale? Yes, you are having small doubt, isn't it? Why they have put here distance, how they can take the distance, isn't it? Scale means it is distance on the ground and the distance between the map. If ground it is 2 km, then we will have here a scale. Scale, how you can take that? Centimeters you can take that. Yes or not? Or inches you can take that. Okay. So scale is a distance between the map and distance on the distance from the ground. According to the ground, for example, school only this much big, this room is only this much big. So we cannot draw like that, isn't it, children? So that according to the classroom distance, we are taking through the scale. What you are using geometry, that scale, no, that scale we are using through drawing the map. So it is based on, it is a diagrammatical representation of the whole earth drawn on a map according to the scale. So that is called map. Okay, who am I making the map? First person, Claudius Ptolemy. What is that? He was a Greek person, Claudius Ptolemy. He was first map, geographical map he was made. This art of map making, it is called cartography. What is that? Cartography. Those who are making or art of making the map, it is called cartography. Okay, this map, we are divided into two types. One is map based on the scale and map based on the purpose. Yes, based on the scale, already you know that. For example, India's land boundaries, how much it is there, that much we will take the scale and we are locating or the drawing on the sketch map, isn't it? And map based on the purpose. For example, I already said, what is that? Political map and the physical map. Political map means what? Okay. Political, in a political map, we are learning countries, locations, cities, towns, boundaries like that, children. Okay. And in a physical map, what we can see? For example, this is a physical map. What we can see? Water bodies we can see, continents we can see, and small lakes and mountains we can see, isn't it? For example, it is Himalaya. So here Himalayan boundaries, isn't it? Then here Arctic Circle and here Antarctic Circle. Yes or no? So then what are the these green color it will indicate? Yes, it will indicate the plain land. Yes or no? For example, in India, Himalayan mountain, then northern plain, then the brown color it is or yellow color it is having the highlands or the plateau system. Then here water pot, blue color it will shows you water pot. So like these we are learning. Okay, so it will help. So map will help to locate all the countries. Then distribution map. Distribution map means agricultural, minerals, industries, and some other forests or the rainfall, temperature, everything what we are having the maps, no, that is called distribution map, children. Okay, I already said that map based on the scale. Here, that scale also two types. One is large scale, means large scale map. For example, this is a large scale map. We can hang it on the wall, isn't it? And secondly, small scale map. In the large scale map, here We cannot see the Sirsi zone, isn't it? Children? Only India we can identify. But Sirsi or Uttar Kannada, what are the district? These are all we cannot, isn't it? For example, if you are taking an India map, then you will have every details. Or else, you are having the Karnataka map, then you will get the Uttar Kannada also, isn't it? So, that is called small scale. This is called large scale. So, these large scale map, it is, we can hang it on the wall. Include all the large scale. Large scale map, it will be locating or the location, very less location we can see there. But in the small scale map, very largest information we will get it in the small scale map, children. Apart from that, in this map, children, one is Atlas. Have you heard the name of Atlas? Have you seen that? Yes. It is a book of map, children. Every details, for example, we wanted to study only India and Karnataka and about all other districts like that. Then what we can, where we can get it through the Atlas, isn't it? Or else, only South America we want to learn. Then we will have the details of in book of map. So that is called Atlas. So in this Atlas, we can see all the continents, forest, mountain type, all the physical features, political features, everything. We have our distribution, industry, minerals, like that. Every details of the map we will get it on in small book, okay? But it will give you, it is a small book, but it will give you large information. So that is called Atlas, okay? It is a book of map. Okay, children, so what is the globe? Miniature model of the earth is called globe. What is the map? Dichromatic earth's representation according to scale, it is drawn on a map. It is called What is cartography? It is art of making the maps. It is called cartography. What is the atlas? A book of map is called atlas. Okay, what are the types of the maps, children? Two types. One is map based on the scale and map based on the purpose. Again, map based on the scale, large scale map and the small scale map. And the map based on the purpose, political map, physical map and the distribution map, you can see. Now, we will have the one more. What is that? Components of map. For example, already we have located here on the globe, north, south, east, west, isn't it, children? So, same thing here in the map also, we are having the directions, title. For example, it is a world map. There is a title. Have you heard that? Vishwa, or what is that? World map, that is written on the up or the down, children. Then one more thing we are having in the colors. What is this? It is called index for the key. Means according to this color we can read the map, children. For example, it may be blue color. Blue color, it will symbols. What is that? It is a water body. Green color, it is a plain land. Flat use, brown it is mountain, yellow or the pink color it is highlands or the plateaus. So like the or the desert, everything we will learn through these symbols, children. Okay, then direction. Always on the map there is a direction. For example, here can you see that this zone? Yes, always the direction will shows the arrow mark of north. According to that arrow mark, we are finding all other direction. For example, north, here what we can see? Arctic, isn't it? Arctic Ocean. And here southern part, isn't it? Antarctic continent, isn't it, children? And the same way, in the eastern part and the western part. Western part, what we are having is, what is that? North America and South America. And eastern part, what we are having here? Australia is there and the Pacific Ocean is there, isn't it? So north, south, east and the west. So like this direction, it will helps. Okay, so first of all, direction. Secondly, title. For example, India physical map, India political map, or North America, map of South America, map of Australia, or world map. Like that, we are having the title, name. Then scale, already I said, according to the distance on the ground and distance of the man. So they are using scale, isn't it? That is scale. For example, latitude and the longitude base, we are all here. Continent is located. For example, here 0 degrees also they have mentioned. This 0 degree at the London, it is the biggest. Sorry, it is not the biggest, but 0 degree it is having. It is from England. Sorry, it is not England. France. Okay, London, and Africa. Again, it will reaches to Antarctica. So this is called Greenwich Meridian or Prime Meridian. So from the 0 degree, all other latitude it will have a distance. Here they have taken the scale or the measurement from the 0 degree east and the west. For example, in the eastern part it is 180 degree, as well as the western part again it is 180 degree. So according to these meridians or the longitude meridians, so our time zone also decided. For example, India, here it is there. So according to 82.5 degree, so 82.5 degree, it is longitude passes through the here. Okay, so almost in this direction. So this is gives you Indian Standard Time, means IST. What is that? Indian Standard Time. Whole country will be applying 82.5 degree. Okay, that will apply the whole country same time. That's called IST, Indian Standard Time. Okay, one more, it is Prime Meridian. It is also it will also indicate time. Okay, apart from that, whole earth, how much degree it is? For example, if you are taking the globe, how much degree it is? 360 degree. So western part it is 180 degree, and eastern part again 180 degree, and it is a vertical line of longitude from north to south. Okay, so then latitude, I already said that. What is that latitude? From west to east it will be rotating. When the earth is rotating, the latitude also it will be rotating. There are 5 latitudes, isn't it, children? Okay, next last one is index or key. I already said that here the color mentioned, that will helps you recognizing the political or the physical features. Okay, not only this much, they were having, for example, when you are traveling, just they are putting the board like hospital means it, here is a hospital, or lodge, here is a hotel or the lodge. So like that they are mentioning, isn't it? Or the church. So like that they are symbol, that is called symbols. That symbols they are mentioning in the map. So through the symbols we can read the map very easily. One is title, scale, latitude and longitude, index or key. So these are all, it will helps to read and locate the map very easily, children. But before that, you have to know about these components. Okay, so it will helps you very easily. Okay, children. Then yes, index or key. For example, page number 144 you are having here. So there is some index or the keys are there. Means capital, Indian capital, which are that? Yes. What is that Indian capital? Delhi, isn't it? So capital they are making like this red color circle, isn't it? And river circle, for example, a blue color they are showing, or like this, if they are giving, means what is that? It is shows you river, children. And it is shows you on the red color, that is capital. Okay, this is river. Or another thing is, what is that? It is railway line. What is that? Railway line. So like that it will shows you the keys, children. Apart from that, I already said that page number 142 latitude and the longitude they have given in the world map, children, just to go through this. Okay, then what is the difference between the political physical map as well as the globe and the map, everything you should learn that children. Okay, next two. Okay, so whatever the problem is there, what is the problem is there? First, how you can refer the map, how you can identify the map, isn't it? You locate the places first. Before that, where is that to locate? According to the direction or the title or where there is in the latitude, everything you can see. That means you can read the map. Okay. Then secondly, find the direction. Which direction it is there? So, for example, India, where we are in the Asian continent. Asian continent lies in the northern hemisphere, isn't it? So, like that you can take the, what is that? Above the equator, that is northern part. Below the equator, it is southern part. So, like that you can read the map, children. Then, find the distance. For example, from North America to India, you can find the distance through the map, children. Okay? So, that is, you are... That is the way of reading the map. Any doubt in this lesson, you can WhatsApp me, children. Thank you. Thank you very much.